So we'll start with the session in opening balances and opening stock. What is opening balance and what is opening stock? Opening balances are the carried forward balances. Either if any client who has been maintaining the accounts in separate software or in manual books, from that book begin date, that is the cutoff date, from the book begin date, he will make note of all the customer wise closing balances as opening balances here, as well as product wise closing stock as opening stock in max. And from here on, all the purchases will add to the stocks and sales will reduce the stock. Same way, all the sales will add to the customer balances and payments will automatically reduce the balances. So continuity will happen from here on. Opening balances for customers and suppliers generally is being maintained bill wise. If you have that maintained bill wise enabled in the customer master, it will ask you for the bill wise detail. Assuming for a particular customer, if there are three bills of different values, let's see an example directly. So where do you find the opening balances? It will be under accounts and opening balance. So we'll click this opening balance and we'll just select a first customer saying Rajputana Enterprises, Mumbai. So it automatically gives the city and it says the group name, customer accounts, and it's asking how much was the opening balance. This opening balance is as on the book begin date. Okay. Okay. It will get recorded in the book begin date only. Any alteration to the opening balances can also happen only in the financial year where the book was begun. Now if we do a transaction for 5 years and suddenly we want to change the opening balance for that year, it's not possible. You'll have to go to the switch to the year in which you have began the book, and from there you have this menu will also open only in that year. Okay, so let's say assuming Rajputana Enterprises has an opening balance of 1 lakh rupees. Next thing it will ask is the bill wise detail. So for 1 lakh, how many bills were there and who was the salesperson? If you have any salesperson, otherwise you can directly mention it direct, and you can mention, let's say, the bill number 111, dated 1416, or let's say 1417, and the due date also either can be 1117 or can be around, if it's a 60 days due date that has been provided, it can even be like 1 March 17. And if the entire 1 lakh is in single bill means, you can mention a single bill itself, 1 lakh. If there are multiple bills, and let's say the first bill is for 60,000 rupees, and then let's say one more other bill number 222, some random one. I'm just giving a random number here, and let's say this bill was for 1st February 17, and the due date was for again 31/3/17. So this 1 lakh rupees has been split among two bills. Able to follow? That 1 lakh rupees of opening balances. There are two bills pending, basically. For the previous year or the date before the book begin date. Either it can any bill which is before the book begin date. If there are 10 bills due for 1 lakh or for 5 lakhs, you mention the opening balance is 5 lakh rupees and mention the bill details. This is for quick reference purpose. Tomorrow we will, once we see the bills outstanding report, we'll get this details in that. And whenever we see the customer's ledgers also, this detail will be with us for reference purpose. When customer says how 1 lakh that is not due, then we can quickly come to this. This is the bill number
of the previous year,
before the begin date. Whatever is the bill number on which we have sold. So tomorrow we will have details in hand where we can tell customers that in bill number 111, which was dated on this date, 1117, that was 60,000 due. So it will even be easy for reconciliation between the customers. Now I will save this. Same way, now it's asking for the next one. Next one, let's say we create another customer, Deepak Traders. Let's say 2 lakhs. Maybe the 2 lakh is all in a single bill itself. Okay, Deepak is a supplier. Deepak Trader is a sundry creditor. So for him also, I am putting an opening balance where I am supposed to pay him. Maybe I would have purchased goods for 2 lakh and bill number 4254. Dated 1617. See, if you enter a date which is after the begin date, then it won't accept. For example, if I give 1/8, what is the begin date? I think we have given us 1. If I give, let's say, current date itself, this date will not be accepted after the begin date. I'll just have to check that. But anyways, this date and the due date both has to be before the begin date only. Due date can be later one also, but has to be more than the invoice date. Let's say we purchase during 1/7 and the due date is 1/8. If I give due date as 1/6, it will show an alert also. It won't let us save. Anyways, 2 lakh rupees in a single bill only. Let's say there's an invalid date here. Invalid date should be less than the company's begin date. So company's begin date, I think it's 1/4 only. So we'll have to give us 1/3. And again, once I save this, due date of 1/7 is accepted because this is greater than this, which means the supplier has given us 120 days of credit days kind of thing. So let's say in the, even the due date I'll change to 1/5 or 1/4. So for Deepak Traders, entire thing is into.
Yes.
Likewise, our capital account, 2 lakh rupees single bill. There I have split into two bills. So I can split into n number of bills as per my transaction that have been recorded. And in case if I want to alter an opening balance again, let's say Rajkumar Enterprises, instead of 1 lakh, it was 1,50,000. Or Deepak, instead of 2 lakhs, it was in two bills rather than one bill. And I can click here again and I click bill wise details. I can click on that particular customer row and click on bill wise detail and change the amount here, saying let's say this is for 80,000 rupees. And then again one more bill. Has to be 70. So now we have split this into two. In case if you want to delete the opening balance, you select that particular row and you can click delete. If you want to add opening balance for one more account, just come to the last row and type the name. So this is a single screen where we add up all the opening balances bill wise. Capital account can also be mentioned here, stock in trade account. If you have any opening balance for stock in trade, you can just select stock in trade account here and mention an opening balance for 5 lakh rupees. Stock in trade has been added. So able to follow with the opening balances? Editing opening balances, bill wise. Deleting the value. See, stock in trade is not a customer account, so it is not asking any bill wise detail. It's a direct value. If I want to change anything in the value, I can directly come here, type the new value saying 2,50,000 and save. Done. When it's a bill wise detail, it will ask you even adjust the bill wise information correctly. Now where? Yes. Now where is it impacting? You can see this report. Accounts coming to bills outstanding, and I see bills receivable. When I see receivables, it will give me two bills for Rajputana. So it says Rajputana, there are two bills pending. You can see on the screen. That 1 lakh rupees of opening balance is split among two bills. So two bills are pending. Now when I will take the receipts from the customer, when customer pays, we will enter a receipt entry. It will ask against which bill are you adjusting the amount. Clear?
This is 60,000 showing and you are showing 1 lakh.
No, that is the running total. This is the running total column.
Okay.
This is the bill wise balance. Total balance is being shown. And the number of overdue days also. There's been 219 days since the payment has come. It's been 219 days since the bill has been raised and payment has not yet come. This is 189 days. So even getting the overdue days, even the due date is being displayed here. When we see the ledger of Rajkumar Enterprises, it will give us an opening balance. There's an opening balance of 1 lakh rupees. When we see bill wise, it gives a split of the opening balance. So clear with the opening balances, editing opening balances, deleting opening balances, and updating the bill wise details. Next, we'll understand opening stock. For opening stock, we have to go to inventory menu and select the first option, opening stock. What is opening stock? The carry forward stock that was available before we started in Max. So let's assume today I am starting in software, or as per the begin date we have started software as on 1/4. So on 31st March, whatever was the closing stock left with us, that will enter as an opening stock in the software so that we can carry forward from there on. So we'll just select Parker Pen. So Parker Gel Pen, how much stock do we have in the beginning? So current stock, it shows we have 0 pieces in hand. And this voucher will purely have an impact on stock only. There's no impact on the accounts. It will not add up to any, it will just have an impact on stock valuation. So let's say I had an opening piece of 100 pieces in hand of 40 rupees each. So 4000 as the stock value that has come. Let's say Parker ink pen. So it is even showing the image. For the products where we have linked an image, it will even show the image, plus it will show the description also, the remarks that we entered, the technical specification. So this can even be displayed here, as well as it can be displayed in the printout also, we can configure it. We can search a product by a wildcard search where I can just type IN and PA, it will still search that anyways. Or I can just write PA and PE and then GE, it will still search. Any combination of searching. Plus it will search by product code also. If I just mention P1002, it will still search. Okay. So let's say I select the second one. Parker ink pen, 200 pieces. And then we had a classmate book, it's a 300 pieces. See, automatically codes are being generated, P1001, 1002, as per the alias setup that we have done. Now, we did not mention any cost rate for the third product, so it is showing zero. So what is the stock cost value? You can mention it here itself. Let's say this pen and this 100 pages book is for 30 rupees. I can just mention this. So my total stock value is 18,000 and I can save this. Maybe I have missed out on some other products now. Opening stock is also running as a voucher. So the second voucher has come now. First voucher, maybe I have taken all the pens. Second voucher, maybe I have taken all the books. Third voucher, I can take all the compost boxes or something. Fourth, I can take some other stationery. So I can split opening stock among multiple vouchers, but it won't make any impact. Either you do it all in one or you split into multiple things. So it's possible that all the opening stock.
Same like opening stock and opening. The same like opening stock and opening balances.
Opening balances for accounts, opening stock is for inventory.
And then we have option for bill wise in the retail.
Here there's no bill wise detail coming in. See, there's other concept where you'll have batch wise detail. When you go to pharmacy, they'll have different batches with different expiry date.
Yes.
So in that scenario, if we enable that batch wise concept, opening stock will ask you the batch wise details for the product. When you give 100 pieces for a particular tablet, example in the pharmacy thing, and that 100 might be into different batches. One might be have been purchased in month of January, other purchase would have been in March, and other purchase in month of, let's say, April. And all these three together will be in different batch numbers. Each medicine will come with a batch number on its box. Batch number could be like some random number, B1, B2, B3. And each batch will have its own expiry date. Something which has been purchased in the month of January, which has been produced or manufactured in January, and with 2 years expiry, it might be expiring in 2018 or 2019 in January again. So we will have a separate expiry date for that. The second batch will have a different expiry date and might be different costing also. So when we are maintaining stocks batch wise, it will ask you the description of this, it will ask you the split of this 100 into multiple batches. Since we are using it as a general product, we have not yet come to the batch wise concept now. We will have a separate session on advanced inventory where we will understand about batch and other product types that we have. But once we come to batch, you will have to give the split batch wise for all the products. In max, we have a possibility where certain products can be batch wise, certain product can be general. We can maintain both kind of products in it. Yes. Someone who is dealing in pharmacy but might even have some accessories or some other general products which are not having an expiry date. So for those, we can just keep it as a general product where we can directly mention their opening stock. It will not ask for any other details. But the product which is defined as batch wise in the product master, then for that, the batch details it will ask definitely.
Okay, and what is the purpose of having opening stock in terms of provisions?
So when we import data from Excel, there's even an option where even the account balances, the opening balances can be imported from Excel in one shot. But only thing is it has to be in a max opening stock template, opening balance template, where we can even mention bill wise detail of each customer and we can import, it will import all the details in one shot in the opening balances. Same way for the opening stock also, we have an Excel template through which we can import. But sometimes the volume of data is so high that products might be 10,000, but for the 10,000 products, if you consider inventory batch wise, when we go to big stores like textile stores, they will have lakhs of pieces in the store, and that lakhs of pieces concept is all barcoded. Barcode is internally a batch only. and those lakhs of pieces, when we try importing in the system, it will take a lot of time. So we generally save them in 100 products in a single voucher. So that way we will have multiple vouchers created automatically once the import process happens. That will even save time, that will even execute things faster. And whenever you want to load and edit something in one particular voucher, so instead of opening a voucher with 1 lakh product details, you open something with 100 and you quickly alter something and you save it. So that will actually improve the performance. So this option is kept as a voucher type kind of thing. Opening stock, if you even have multiple warehouse enabled, warehouse model is also there, then you have to mention this 100 pieces to be splitted among different warehouses. Let's say I have one warehouse inside the store, one in a neighbor street. I have 200 pieces or I have 100 pieces of particular gel pen, 80 in the warehouse, 20 in the store. So I have to give the split of this 100 into warehouse wise. If we have batch wise also, then we have to go batch wise and then warehouse wise. This batch is in this warehouse, this much quantity. This batch is in store, this much quantity. We'll understand the warehouse concept also in a later date in a separate session. That's the advanced inventory which we are talking about. There, even the warehouse and the batch concept will come into picture. So this is clear with the opening stock. You can have multiple vouchers, you can go previous next, and this is the stock value. Now after opening stock, we'll just come back to this inventory. See, all the menus that you are seeing here, today we are going to learn about sales, purchase, accounts and inventory. So first set of menu is transactions. You can see the transaction info and you can find a divider in between. And then second set of menu is all reporting. Okay, so reports are all about, you click and find the report and the details. First set of transactions are the entry points. You have to enter the data here. Based on this data, you can see different reports that are being generated. Same in the purchase also, first set of menu is all about transactions, second set of menu is all about reports. Okay, so coming to inventory, first set of menu is all transactions, second set of menu report. We are just seeing the stock summary. So as per the opening stock that we entered, once we see the stock summary, it says Classmate, we have 300 pieces. By default, everything lies into the primary warehouse. Internally, once you create a book, a default warehouse gets created as a primary. Then we have group name called pen. Under pen, we have two products, Parker gel pen and ink pen, and their quantities also as entered in the opening, it shows. Total pen, we have 300 pieces, splitted among 100 and 200. Same way books, we have a single thing, Classmate, so all 300. And total stock valuation is 18,000. Yesterday when we discussed about the manual stock process here in the masters, the closing stock. See, by default, the balance sheet will pick up the stock value that is being available in the stock summary, 18,000 rupees. But as this might change as per the different times, because there are different valuation method available, like average cost rate or as per the last purchase rate, because something where the cost has increased, then your entire stock, whatever is lying with you, would be valued as per the current rate only, correct? Automatically as per the last purchase rate. See, something which you bought rupees, but today that pricing is 150 rupees. Then your stock value will be showing you as per the 150 rupees only. But that is not correct. Somewhere you purchase in 100, rate have fluctuated, it has become 150 now, and you're generating more profits out of it. But balance sheet stock valuation will be showing as per the current rate. For certain business it is okay, but for certain business the stock valuation of current date is not correct, because that will again go back to 120 later also. So they will prefer having the exact rate on which they have purchased. So that will be like a FIFO method, first in first out basis. There's an option of calculating stock valuation as per the FIFO method. But apart from that, let's understand this part now. By default, balance sheet will take up this value of 18,000 rupees. And if you have mentioned the closing stock value in the masters, then there's an option in the balance sheet where you can fix that value instead of this. That will help you in adjustment on the net profits. So till here it's okay. Now once we press and enter here, it shows me from where this 300 has come. So it shows that it's an opening stock number 1, voucher number 1, and 300 pieces have come inward into this, 30 rupees each, so 9,000 rupees is the value. When you press enter there, you can jump into the details. Able to follow with it? Press enter. Which one? This one. First stock summary. Inventory, stock summary. Click show. It will show you all the stocks. Now, how did this value arrive? You can press enter. And you can see this is the opening stock. You press enter, you get the transactions. All these windows are opening here, if you can see. Parallelly, all the windows are opening here. You can just press escape and jump into the last one. Okay. Now we'll just see a direct purchase entry. Once we go to purchase, we have multiple options: purchase order, receipt note approval, and purchase and a purchase return. So we'll understand this concept later. We'll directly go to purchases for now. So going forward with the purchases, we go to purchase menu for now. We'll just understand what is a purchase order. Purchase order is something which we are raising to our supplier, like just a order that we have placed against which they'll send us the goods. So we can keep a track of what we have, how many quantities we have placed order for, how much they have sent us, how much is pending. We can keep a track that way. Receipt note is something where we are giving confirmation that the goods have been received. It will start affecting the stock from where we can start selling. But maybe if the supplier invoice has not yet come, we can still enter a good receipt note. On a later date, we can convert a receipt note to a purchase directly. Stocks are getting impacted here. There's no impact on accounts. In order, there's no impact on stocks as well as accounts. We're just placing a verbal communication that we want this much of products to the vendor. When you understand about impact on stock and impact on accounts, there's no change happening to the supplier balances, no change happening to the stock balances.
Your receipt note is, imagine I bought a stationery shop. Now I order certain things from you, like I want notebooks, I want pens and so on. So receipt note is, I'm buying and we're getting things from receipt.
That is a direct purchase.
Okay, so what is receipt note then?
I'll come back to that later. Let's see the purchase part in the session.
Okay.
For example, I placed an order and I have got the goods, but I did not get the invoice from the supplier still.
Okay.
And that way, I cannot raise a purchase bill.
Okay.
But what I'll do is I'll just enter a receipt note. And I've received the goods. That's the confirmation. This way, I'll get the stock added in my inventories. And then only I'll be able to make the sales.
Okay.
Order can be converted to a receipt note or to a purchase directly. And receipt note can also be converted to a purchase directly in one click. You need not type all the data again, all the product and the quantity information. Okay. We'll understand the purchase first and then we'll again have separate session on purchase order and receipt note. So purchase, as we come to purchase, it is asking, saying the reference number one, what is the invoice number? So invoice number, the supplier's invoice number. When we are buying something from one of the vendor, they will raise a bill and give it to us. So what is that bill number that against which we have got the goods? It's a vendor's invoice number 111. The date of entry, the actual invoice date. You guys can understand the concept first, then focus on the notes. First understand it, later on you'll have sufficient time to take your notes again. So what is the difference between date of entry and actual invoice date? Date of entry is the date on which I'm entering recording the details in our system. The invoice date, maybe it can be a couple of days earlier where I purchased the goods, but it took 2 days for it to come in for the transport and to get it delivered in our premises. So date of entries might be today's date and invoice date might be 2 days earlier also. Generally this is the scope, but in most of the business both the dates will be same only by default. They'll keep it same. So whether it's a cash purchase or a credit purchase, we can even select that here. So let's say by default it's a credit purchase. Cash purchase means
cash.
We have paid the cash and we have bought the goods. Credit purchase means we are yet to pay to the vendor. Invoice amount. It's asking the invoice amount at the beginning itself. What is the purpose? To avoid mistakes. See, well, let's say I enter an invoice number of 10,000 here. Invoice amount 10,000. And then I select my vendor saying Deepak Traders. So Deepak Traders belongs to Tamil Nadu only. So it's a local. So since it's a local trader, you are getting SGST and CGST here. And we had one more vendor from the outstation, Sri Varu. Once you select Sri Varu, it brings IGST automatically, single tax code. So we'll see both the cases. We'll just enter a couple of things here. Let's say taking Deepak Traders. So once we select Deepak Traders, it gives me a performance graph of last 12 months for Deepak Traders. On which all month, how much purchase we have made, how much order we have placed, how much returns we have given, how much payment we have made. All the details will come in this graph. If there's any agent in between, see, we created one agent, Shyam and Suresh. These are all the purchase agents that are in between. In case we are buying goods against any of the agent name, you can select that agent name here. Okay, so invoice amount and grand total has to match for us to save this transaction. If this invoice amount and this grand total is not matching, it won't let us save this purchase transaction. why this lock in between. So as and when we enter the transaction details, it will keep on calculating the grand total automatically for each product. So in case if we missed out on any of the expenses or any discount, or mistakenly we have typed some wrong rate, or we missed out any of the products on the purchase, or typed a wrong quantity, this total and this total will not match. This is the grand total of the supplier bill which we are seeing in the beginning and entering here itself. We are seeing the bill number, we are seeing checking the bill date, and we are typing the grand total at the beginning. So that by this there is a 100% accuracy in the purchase part. You are not missing out or you are not doing anything wrong. Everything will go accurately. Otherwise you won't be able to save the transaction. So assuming, let's say in this transaction we are buying Parker gel pen. We already have 100 pieces in the stock which we entered in the opening. Let's say we are buying another 50 pieces at 40 rupees each. Then second we are buying Chai Parker ink pen, other 40 pieces at 25 rupees or the 1000 rupees. And then we are buying a Chai Classmate book. Let's say 100 pieces at 25 rupees or 28 rupees this time. And if this is sufficient, means, or let's say we will increase in. Okay, so this is done. Then it's asking for the expenses. So internally it is calculated, this is the turnover 8600, on which there's a 18%, 5% and 12%, all three taxes are coming in, which are being splitted among SGST and CGST. So 8600 and the total tax amount is 1082, and the balances we can just have it. Let's say in order to bring it to 10,000, either I can change this value to 9682 and close the purchase temporarily because we are just doing a dummy entry here, or else I'm just entering a 300 rupees or 320 rupees as an expenses. Making it 10,000, it is rounded off to minus 2 automatically. At the bottom you can see round off minus 2. So when mentioned as 320, the total was going up to 10,002, and minus 2 has been provided as a round off, and this total has come as 10,000. And this, if you have any other remarks also, you can mention the remarks. Or sent by courier or whatever it is. Any remarks you can type in, you can save this transaction. So we'll come back to the same transaction and see the details. So we've ordered this, I mean we have purchased this three product, this is a complete purchase thing recorded with the expenses, and the bill total is 10,000 rupees, which we are yet to pay to the vendor. Okay. Now going back to this, so there are a few other options here. In the options we have status report, like voucher status. What is the voucher status? So whether we have made any payment against this particular purchase, that can be seen here itself. Or sometimes it can even be a chance where we have adjusted a return against this. From this particular purchase, we have sent back few goods worth 2000 rupees. Then even it will show that 10,000 is for the purchase, 2000 for the purchase return, balance is 8000 pending. That is also a possibility. Or we have made a part payment against this purchase, then the balance will. So anything which is linked with this purchase will be shown here. History option will give you the account history. Once you click account history, it will give you the complete history of transaction that has happened between Deepak Traders and you. So there's only a single purchase that has happened in these three products you have dealt with till date. Same way, you click any of the product and you can just click options and history, and you can just see the product history. So currently it will show you the Parker ink pen product history. So it says it has come only from Deepak Traders, we don't have any other transaction for this product. Summaries, if you want to see what is the tax summary detail, you just click this. It will give you a summary that GST 5%, 1000 rupees is the turnover. See, as per the transaction that we have here, 1000 rupees is for 5%. So 5%, 25 rupees SGST, 25 rupees SGST, and the total split has come. Same way, 12% is 5600 rupees. So this 5600, 12% split has 6 and 6. So 336 and 336 is the tax amount on this 5600, totaling up to this much. And third product, 18% for this 2000, 18%. 180 and 182. All this total is totaling is up to 9682, which we are seeing as a subtotal here. 9682. I mean this both together. And then 320 rupees is the expenses, which is making up to 10,000. Now currently after GST, there is even a chance where there's they have informed that expenses also should have taxes. So to enable that, there are settings involved. I'll just do the setting for now in this, or we can even do this configuration later. We'll have understand this later. Then we can even see the product summary, what all products we have bought in this purchase. So we'll give you a quick summary of what products we have bought. If the purchase, this is a small transaction, if it's a big transaction, you can quickly identify which all products you have bought or what all groups you have bought. From here itself, you can add the, update the GST number of the customers, you can add a product code, and you can update the HSN bar GST percentage for a particular product. Import and export option is also available, where you can import the product details from some other voucher. So instead of typing it again, you can import it or copy it from some other voucher also. Reference report, it will give you the ledger entries also. Now in this purchase, at the back end on the accounting part, what has happened? So ledger entries will share the debook status 10,000 spending. And this 10,000 has been split into GST 18% turnover, GST 5% turnover, GST 12% turnover, and their respective taxes in SGST account and CGST account, round off 2 rupees, expenses 320 rupees. The entire back end account part split has been displayed here itself. What are the other reports? User action log. So which user has added when? So this date, this time, add action has happened by admin user. This is the bill amount. Now, just for our understanding, if I just click edit and save, and I go back to previous, it will keep a log of all the actions that has happened. So you go to references again, see user action log. It says on this date and this time, edit action has happened by the admin user. I'm the current user, admin user login. What was the amount currently and what is the old amount? What was the old date? Okay. So complete action log happens, you know, which user has done the mistake, or we can quickly identify anything which has went wrong. References will give you other details, like if this has been converted from a sales order or a DC, so from where it has come from, that detail will come here. A purchase can be linked, connected to a purchase order. I have raised an order, they have sent the goods, and I'm linking that order to this purchase. So that will, it will show a link that from this order you have converted this purchase, and the pending order will be left. If you have ordered for 100 or 1000 pieces of classmate book, 200 has been supplied here in this purchase. So it will connect that out of 1200 has been supplied in this purchase bill, remaining 800 is pending. That linking will be there. We'll understand about that in the purchase order session. Product price comparison. So if you are buying this product from multiple vendors, it can even show you which all vendors are supplying this product and the last transaction detail on from which vendor, on which date, how much quantity we bought, at what rate. So we can have a price comparison of the products from multiple vendors. Then we can attach documents against it. N number of documents can be attached against this voucher. Again, attached documents can be from webcam, or you can browse and select any PDF, or if you have any transporter copy or any purchase order copy you want to attach with this document, you can attach here. In future, you can quickly come to this voucher again, see whatever is the document attached with it. Basically, you can make it completely paperless. All your operations you can scan and keep it in the system. So that even if paper is damaged or lost, you will still have all the relevant records in your system along with the respective voucher. You can set a reminder for this voucher. Let's say if you want any reminder for this voucher after 15 days. You can set a reminder, and based on that reminder, you will get alerts on the screen. Copy voucher. If you click this, it will just replicate this copy, I mean make a copy of this purchase, wherein you can just quickly make any changes, change the vendor name, just to avoid your data entry work. Or you can copy this purchase to sales also. You click copy voucher, it will ask you where do you want to copy. So I just click copy to sale. I click proceed. As it is, this transaction will get copied to sales voucher. All this entry has come. So you are seeing the purchase here and the sales is coming here. You can change the customer name here and you can directly save. Goods return. What does this mean? Purchase return. Purchase return. So let's say in this particular voucher itself, something is damaged or it's not come correctly. I can either give goods return and return the complete purchase. It will automatically generate a purchase return with all the details here. Now if I just click save, 10,000 rupees goods is going back to Deepak Traders. If something has particularly come wrong, then I can remove those two products. Let's say out of this, I'm only returning goods for, let's say 10 pieces are damaged or something is wrong. Then I can just save this. It is asking me against which purchase are you saving this. So Deepak traders opening balances of two bills are coming and the third bill of 10,000. So against this 10,000, 790 rupees returns I'm doing and adjusting it. Able to follow? Purchase return, either you go it manually, you can go to this menu option purchase return and then type the Deepak traders and you can type the product which you are returning back and then save it against a rate and adjust it against an existing bill office, or you can even do it from the
options,
from the options for quick references. Next we have a couple of more options like monitor this voucher. Monitor this voucher will help you in keeping a track of, see, once we set a monitor on a voucher, this is a special feature that we have. This voucher will get locked. No one will be able to edit it unless it is unmonitored again, right? It's demonitored again. Once we keep monitor this voucher, there's a separate report available in miscellaneous menu where you can see a list of monitor vouchers. Let's say there's something wrong in this transaction or you're not sure about something on this transaction. And so you can monitor this voucher and keep it on hold. And then you can have a separate list where you can see the list of monitored vouchers quickly. Or maybe if you want to consult with someone on those set of vouchers, so instead of finding it again here and there, you can mark a monitor here itself. Later you get a report of list of all the monitor vouchers. You can open one by one. If everything is okay, you can unmark it again from the monitor, demonitor it again. Send SMS. You click this and you can send a quick SMS to the Deepak traders if this mobile number is entered. Then you have some configuration menus where different kind of configuration. You can enable discounts, you can create different expenses, you can enable tax on expenses. There are a lot of things. You can even define custom fields each product wise or for the entire purchase voucher. Enable filtering and sorting will give you one row here additionally where you can quickly find out a particular product in that purchase. Able to follow? There are a few other options here, like other details. What is there in other details? So I can even store the LR number. LR number is the lorry receipt number from which transport it has come from. What was the lorry receipt date? The transporter name, number of boxes that I have got, from which vehicle number I have purchased these goods. This is the additional information against which and how much is the credit days is being provided by this vendor on this particular purchase. See, by default it's 0 days, means it is coming on the same date. It's outstanding, it's liable to be paid on the current date itself. But if you mention 30 days here, let's say I just mention, I have to click edit first. I go to other details and this I click 30 days. When I mention 30 days, this bill is due after 30 days. So it automatically brings 5th November by 11. And you have some DC number. DC number is the delivery challan number, which is what we discussed was the receipt note. Receipt note, approval, delivery challan, delivery note, everything is all same. So DC number, DC date. Again, we can even mention an order number also against which the goods are coming here. If we are directly converting it from a delivery challan or an order, these details will come automatically. But if we are not making a note of order module and all, then we can manually type also. Any description of the goods if you want to type, you can type in here. And you can proceed.
Order number means the purchase.
Purchase order number. So and there's one more option saying, say you can find out quantity, rate, amount, taxes, and then the cost rate and adjustment code. The cost rate is the landing cost basically. Now after paying expenses to the supplier, I still have some additional cost involved, let's say for unloading goods or for some local transportation to my warehouse. I've still added and paid out of my pocket. If I want to add those into the cost, I can have an additional cost option here where I can just mention, let's say local transport, some 100 rupees, let's say unloading 200 rupees. So once I press enter here, it says we want to calculate on the cost. See, there will be no impact on the rate, there will be no impact on the supplier's total anywhere, but it will purely have an impact on our landing cost. See, this additional cost is not having any impact on the accounting part. If you are paid to your local transport vendor or someone for the unloading, then you have to pass separate payment into the accounts. But here, we are just entering those details here and just calculating our landing cost. Once we give yes, it will automatically calculate the cost as per the pro rata basis. 300 rupees has been split into equally as per the amount, as per the ratio of amount. 300 rupees has been divided among all these products and then split it among each of this quantity. So that way 40 rupees has become 41.40, this has become 0.87 additional, and this has become 0.98 additional. total 300 rupees has been added to the cost value for each piece, but there's no impact on the supplier's bill. Okay, it's just our landing cost which is changing, and I save this. Let's say I quickly take one more purchase from what? Let's say I bought bulk pieces of 500 pieces and I have negotiated on pricing and I got it 25 rupees each. And I can save this directly. So it says there's no amount mismatch. Your bill amount is 14,000, you have entered only 5,000. So either this is wrong or that is wrong. For our demo purpose, I'll just change this. That way you'll not have anything going wrong on the purchase. Purchase will have 100% accuracy. What was your question?
We make a purchase order.
Yeah, we can do that. Once we see that order module separately, we'll have a separate session on purchase order and delivery note. That time we'll see the complete flow right from the order. Now we have recorded two purchases, one for IGST and one for local. You go previous, you can see that this is an IGST based purchase and this is a transaction. And I can go previous and still find out Deepak Traders also. This is a local purchase with SGST and CGST. There's one more option where you can even search the customer by previous next, or you can even search it by saying, let's say you can even type the reference number 1 and it will quickly show you. And to avoid mistakes also, if you just mention 111 and enter Deepak Traders again, so same supplier, same bill number will never come again. So if you mention it again, and if there's any old transaction with the same combination, that will open automatically. When a supplier gives us a bill number, his bill number will never be the same.
Okay,
it will be different.
Yes.
So mistakenly, let's say we have four people sitting on the counter and we are entering data, and a bill which has been entered by me and someone else has taken the bill copy again and is trying to re-enter, that will create duplication of products, duplication of entire ledger, as well as double the stock. To avoid that, once you mention the bill number and you mention the customer supplier's name, if that combination of bill is already entered in the system, that will open again. So user will be aware that it's already entered and you not enter it again. Yeah. You can print or you can click delete, you can click cancel, there are a few other options here. If you click delete, the transaction will be deleted. If you click cancel, what is the difference between delete and cancel?
Delete is the whole thing, cancel is only the thing we are trying to cancel.
No, cancel will keep these details in the system without any impact on stocks and accounts. If I click cancel, the stock will get reduced again by all these quantities. Currently it is added, it will get reduced again. Same way supplier ledger also has been added with 10,000 rupees, which is payable. But if I cancel it, it is as good like delete only, but the data will still remain in the system.
Like the control set we can use and we can
take. We can uncancel it again and we can bring it. That is also a possibility. But delete means it will go out of the system. Okay.
Like if you made a purchase and suddenly say
you will destroy. Cancel scenario comes where supplier sent us goods and we did not find pricing to be correct. And we say no, we are sending the goods back. So instead of recording things in the system and then sending a purchase return again and all that, directly cancel the thing itself. Or mistakenly we have typed something. Basically the number will remain blocked and you will find a cancelled option coming at the top of the system. We'll see that scenario also. But cancellation is, record is there in the system, it will show in the purchase register also. And that will be a zero. Generally cancel happens on the sales, not in the purchase. Most of the cancel transaction will happen on the sales only. Sales scenario where on a retail counter the user has permission to add a transaction, but no edit, no delete. But mistakenly has raised a bill and customer said no, I don't want the goods, and he left the counter. During that scenario, user, as per his day summary, it will show you that additional cash has been collected, but basically customer has not even taken the bill and has left the goods and left. So in that scenario, what he will do is he will give a cancel. At the end of the day, when he is submitting the report to the manager, he can find out that today there will be 100 bills generated, out of which this 4 bills has been cancelled. Then he can ask a reason for the cancel also. Yesterday when we saw the reason master under the masters, when we saw this other master, there was a reason option. So in reasons, we can predefine the cancellation reasons. Customer went out, or customer did not have the amount to pay, or customer was just, whatever is the reason. And that reason can be linked along with this cancel. But when submitting for the day end report, the owners have the clarity that 4 bills have been cancelled and they can recheck the stocks also against it. It should not be that customer has taken the goods and the biller on the counter has cancelled the bill and taken the amount. So that way also you can cross check. So generally that edit and delete permissions will not be provided. And neither cancel is being provided, but certain cases they will say cancellation should be allowed, so that at least user can cancel and raise other bill. Mistakenly, if the user has entered, let's say 40 products in the bill, and the customer signed payment of up to 30 products only, and he says no, I don't want the other 10 products, then that scenario will cancel that bill and enter 30 products, raise a new bill, and give it to the customer. So clear with the purchases. There's way where we can configure discounts on the purchase, and we can define the expenses also. For now, I'll just enable the discounts. When you go to options, configuration, there'll be certain settings coming in. So under the settings menu, we have an option where screen invalidations we go to. We'll have a separate session on all the settings, but later, let's understand only the basic one. If you want a product-wise discount which will come with each of the row, then I can enable this. Product-wise discount tool option is also available. Same way, bill-wise cash discount required and bill-wise cash discount amount editable, as well as a second discount on the bill is bill-wise special discount required. If I enable two discounts bill-wise, I save this. To apply this, I just have to close the window and open it again. So product-wise, single discount column has come in the picture, and bill-wise two discounts have come into the picture, cash discount and special discount. Either you can type in percentages here, or you can directly type the value here, bill-wise, and product-wise you can define percentages. Why this discount? For one product you might give 2%, for other product a vendor might give 5%. If you just change, let's say 2% for this product, again 2 for this, 5 for this, then the discount structure has changed completely. I mean, the bill total, everything changes. And on this entire thing, he has given another 20 rupees discount, so you can directly mention 20 rupees here. So accordingly, see, the taxes are being calculated after the discounts. Okay, always the tax calculation will happen after the discount. For a 1000 rupees product, if there's a 10% discount, 900 rupees, and then taxes will be above the 900. So basically here also 1000 rupees, 2% discount, and then the taxes are coming into picture. Same way on the bill also, after the subtotal, the taxes will come into picture. After this discounts, the taxable amount will come, and then on this taxes will get applied.
What happens over here?
No, nothing happens over here. I have mentioned discount here also, I have mentioned discount there also. There are two options. Sometimes some of the vendors will give discount individual product wise. Certain vendors will say, no, I am not giving any product wise discount, on the entire bill you take 5% and finish off. And in that scenario, we will just mention 5% discount on the entire bill.
Okay.
All the products basically are getting discounted by 5%. Or certain scenarios, both discounts could also be possible. They are giving discount product wise also, and then on the bill also they are giving one more extra discount. So that also can be entered. Okay, with the purchases. See, even the sales will have all the similar options, and all the options that we have seen here also will be available in sales. What you have to do is, after this training, you will have to practice this once. Try out all the different options once, nothing will go wrong. Try out, see the impact where it is bringing in, what is the impact happening, and accordingly you will be able to understand it more clearly. One of the important concepts which I did not explain was one more thing here. That's it, 333. Again, I'm just mentioning Deepak Traders here. So once I select Deepak Traders, now it is giving me a performance graph that in October month, this is the highest purchase made, and there's a return also which has happened. You can see the orange color is for return, green color is for purchase. 10,000 rupees purchase, 790 rupees return. Clear? After the performance graph, now when I select Classmate, it is automatically bringing 28 rupees, whereas our costing is 30 rupees as we defined in the opening stock. So why it has brought 28 rupees? It will automatically keep a track of supplier wise, product wise, previous supply rates. When I give 10 pieces and come to rate, once I come to rate, it gives previous supply rate history column at the bottom. Why it is showing that on this date, in this bill number, you have purchased 200 pieces at 28 rupees. This time the supplier is giving at higher rate. Then you can again, while entering itself, you will have an idea that last time he is given at 28 rupees, why this time he is given at 30 rupees. You can again call the customer, ask him to check the last meal and negotiate the pricing. Basically, it will help you out in transaction, dealing, having better transaction. Now this time if I further negotiate and get it at 25 rupees. So next time it will keep a track, whenever you put a purchase of particular this product from Deepak Traders, Classmate 100 pages book, it will bring 25 rupees automatically. We can disable the settings if you don't want, but by default it's all enabled. Supplier wise, last product wise, last supply rate, that will remain in the history also, it will come, it will fetch also automatically. It will even fetch the discount also. Last time you got at 30 rupees with 5% discount, it will bring 30 rupees and 5% discount both. Same way, customer wise, product wise, last supplied history also will come. When there are different pricing going on with customers, let's say I save this purchase, 280 rupees. So I've recorded 3 purchases. As I'm keeping a track of supply wise, product wise, last supply date, same way customer wise, product wise, last supply date will also be in track. In different businesses, they will have different rates for different customers. You may not recollect everything, or you may not remember everything, neither your people will remember everything who is on the counter. So that way, the system will take care of this. So we have seen a purchase, we have seen a purchase item. We'll just see one more report here, purchase register. Purchase register will give you the details of all the purchases made in a particular date range, purchase and returns. So as on current date, by default, once you click show, it will load the report for the current date. So from 6th October to 6th October, it says there are 3 purchases and there's one return which has happened. So total turnover, gross amount, and the taxes, expenses, all the taxes, and then you have the grand total coming. The total purchases you have made for current date is 23,490 rupees. All the reporting will have a similar standard where you have multiple register types where you can find different combination of options available in that report. Different type of reports available basically. When you give columnar tax wise, it will give you tax wise details like Deepak Traders, 12% turnover, 18% turnover, 5% turnover, and the taxes accordingly. Everywhere you press enter, you can jump into the transaction detail and find out what was there. We'll see this more in detail in the sales register. Here you can even find out other summaries like tax summary of the total day or the total date range, the total turnover for different tax slabs and the respective taxes and the grand total. This will be matching with the grand total of the report. You can even choose it for current week. You want to see for current week in this, like this week or previous week or this month, what has the purchases happened. If you select this date range, automatically it will bring the current month date at the top and it will load all the transactions for the current month. You can even give a manual date range by clicking this. You can select your own custom date also. So basically purchase item and its register link. We'll move into the inventory part once again and see what is impacted. So once you see the stock summary now, well, if you click show, it is showing 1000 pieces of this are left, 140 and 240. Again, register type, I have an option where I can see detailed stock summary. When I select detailed stock summary, it will show me what was the opening. So 300 pieces were opening. What was the inward? So 710 pieces of classmate has come inward. We have made a purchase. This is the average date of the purchase. The stock value coming here. Then what is the stock left in hand? There's no output which has happened. We have not yet done any output. No sales has happened. How did this figures arrive? If I just press enter, it will give me opening stock detail and then there's a purchase from Deepak, then Srivaru, again there's a purchase from Deepak. I can move in, drill into the transaction. Okay. Able to follow? We'll come to the sales part of it now. Sales also, same way you have sales order, where for example some customers called up and placed an order over the phone or they have sent mail. We'll drag the order in the system. And this order can even be connected to the Max mobile app, where from the mobile app itself some salesperson has, or even in future, near future, we are bringing the customer can place the order directly. So customer will be having the ability to see what all products we have and whether the inventory should be visible to them or not, or rate should be visible to them or not. That is an optional thing, that will be a configuration. But whatever is the order, they can record the order here and then they can keep a track of pending orders for the customer. Like if a customer has placed classmate book 5000 pieces is required for entire school, example you are dealing with a school and you have only 1000 pieces in hand, so you can place you can record your order for 5000 and then supply 1000 immediately. For remaining 4000 you can raise a purchase order to your vendor and they will supply the goods which will come in the system as a purchase and then you will be recording a sales against it. So orders will help you keeping a track of how many customers, what all they have ordered, how much orders you have in hand, how much you have to purchase, and how much sales is being happening basically. Same way delivery note. Delivery note or a delivery challan is something like I have sent the goods to a particular customer and without raising bill. sometimes two scenarios like in sales. One of my relative have come to the store and he has taken 10 saris to her home. And she says, after the saris, if I like all 10, I'll keep 10. I'll just try it at my home and confirm with others and tell how many I am keeping. So she might keep one also, she might keep four also, or she might keep all the 10 also, or she might return all 10 also. That scenario, I cannot raise a bill right away. I cannot even give her 10 saris and ask her the complete amount. So that way I will just raise a delivery note against her, and system will keep a track that which customer, how much quantities we have given, how much is the value for that quantity, everything. Later on, if she says, okay, all 10 are there, in one click I can convert the delivery note to her invoice, sales invoice. And if she says, no, out of this 10 I'm keeping only 4, then for remaining 6 I can give a delivery return challan, and for 4 I can raise a bill. See, once I give a delivery note, there's no impact on accounts. What do I mean by no impact on accounts? There's no outstanding increasing or there's no turnover increasing. Only thing is, stock is getting reduced in case of sales. 10 saris will get reduced from my stock, and I won't be able to sell to anyone because by default physically the saris have been given to that particular relative. Only impact is on stocks. Sales orders not neither having impact on stocks, neither having impact on accounts. Okay. Then we directly come to the sales invoice. So it can convert a delivery note to an invoice, or order to delivery note to invoice also, or direct order to sales invoice. So I'll just come to sales invoice for now. We'll see how a sales record, I mean, just record a sales transaction. So it's automatically bringing sales number 1. I can even have bill number starting from 1001 or whatever number I want. I can even append prefix and suffix. We'll see those configurations in the next session. Currently, we'll just learn whether it's a cash bill or a credit bill. In case there's a card payment, then we have third option here, others. Others, once we select the others, you can see this option coming at the bottom of the screen. If I go to credit, this option will not come. For others only, it will show you this payment details, where you can collect payment in partial in cash, check or card also. So let's say credit. So I'm giving sales in credit to Rajputana, Mumbai. So once I select Rajputana, the remarks of this customer, which we defined in the master, are coming here. Clear payment terms before billing. I click OK. And then it says there are two bills which are already exceeding the credit days. Which are the two bills? Crossed 30 days. 30 days is the credit days that we have defined in the for this customer. But which two bills? We have not even entered any bill. This is the bill number 1. So which two bills are exceeding the credit days? So from the opening balances where we have divided 1 lakh into two specs. So it's still in alert mode, so it is accepting. But if the credit limit is gone, means it will not accept. So it is even showing the current outstanding of the account. 1 lakh is pending, which is the opening one. And it's giving the customer details here. It is asking us to select the shipping address. Since there are more than one shipping address, it is asking whether you want to ship at the other or Worli. We created multiple shipping address for this customer. So let's say I select the other. So this will come in the bill printout. Who is the salesperson dealing with this? Prem, Suresh, Kumar or direct? Let's say any one salesperson, Kumar. I sell classmate book. I have the current stock of 1010 pieces. I have not defined any sales rate, so it's coming 0 by default. I did not define any rate in the master for this product. Let's say I am selling 100 pieces of it. Again, once I come to rate, it is giving me the previous supply date history. Same way, once we select the account name, it gives the last 12 months performance for the customer also. So let's say I am selling at 35 rupees. As per my dealing over the phone, they have approved at 35 rupees. So 35 rupees kind of thing we have just entered here. Parker pen. By default 50 rupees has come, that is the sales rate that we have defined in the product master. Let's say 40 pieces, customers negotiated and we are giving at 45 rupees. Previous supplied, no history is available, so nothing is coming here. So 45, you are showing me an alert, you are selling less than the sales rate defined of 50. By default, in the product master setup, everything is in alert mode. If we block there, it won't allow us. So it's showing an alert for us so that we can remain aware of that we are doing it lesser than the purchasing. And if we sell it, let's say 20 rupees itself, we are selling lesser than the cost at of 41.39. Even that is in the alert mode. If you block it, it will remain blocked. So let's say I just change back to 45. Third, let's say in pen, 20 pieces at 30 rupees. And then any other expenses, I can again configure discount product wise here. I can configure discounts on the entire bill, as well as I can configure different expenses like courier charges, transport charges. We'll see that in the configuration session, and we'll come back to the screen during the while changing configuration. We'll see the impact of those. And if there's any other expenses, let's say 100 rupees delivery charges, we can just mention this. And then it's asking, once you press enter, it'll ask you for the LR number against which, in which lorry are you sending, what is the LR date. Mahalakshmi lorry that we defined for the other address, it's coming automatically. Maybe for bulky address, we might have some other transporter. Number of cases means number of packets in which we are packing and sending. So let's say two boxes. Vehicle number, what is the lorry number? If there's anything you can mention. Any document, freight, whether it's to be paid or it's already paid by us. Two payments, it will be taken by the customer. And once the goods are delivered, then we are not supposed to put any charges here. The lorry freight person will automatically take it from the Rajputan Enterprises while delivering the goods. Default 30 days has come, so 5th November is the due date. Again, delivery challan number against which we are sending the goods. What is the delivery challan date? Order number, order date. Delivery challan, approval, delivery note, sale challan, all these concepts are same. It's been termed in different terminologies, but everything is same. Here this is in a single screen only. So I'm just proceeding, and then any other remarks if I have sent by I can just save details. It says, do you want to print? I gave yes. It's asking me, how many copies do you want? See, generally there will be multiple copies of printout. Original for the customer, duplicate for us. Or there can be an extra copy, lorry copy separately for lorry person. There can be one extra copy or an office copy. This caption can come above the printout. Basically, it is just multiple copies of the printout, but each of this copy can have this title above in the printing. If you take this two, or if you take this three, one copy will have original coming at the top, second copy will have duplicate, third copy will have triplicate at the top. So seeing that, we can just keep one for office copy, one for lorry person, one for the customer, however we want. We can see a preview or we can directly click print. For now, I'll just click a preview so that we can see what we have introduced, how it's being presented in the bill. So it says credit sales invoice. The lucky name has come here. Original for recipient. Either it will be duplicate, original like this. GST number, since we have not entered, it's coming blank. And the company name and our address and all the details are coming here. Customer name address is coming here. Delivery address, the shipping address has started coming here, you can see. The other Mumbai. And the order details, number of boxes, due date, LR number, LR date, the customer's GST number, the current invoice number date. All the details are coming here with the product information now. Product name, quantity, date, amount. Total quantity, the tax summary, we can get the terms and conditions configured here, we can even have the company's bank detail coming here. And the space for signature also, the receiver signature also. And we can alter this. So we'll understand how to configure this print formats in a separate session. We'll have one session for this, specifically for configuring the print formats. But you can directly send an email from here. You can send an email either as PDF or Excel or some Word document. We can export this detail in so many, this particular voucher in Excel format, again Word document or Excel, some PDF also. I can print an envelope for this customer, for this delivery address or the bill address. Once you can even print an envelope, and you can print the bill and you can courier it. And so we even place another bill for Ashok Opticals. Only one single bill, not to print. Again, I come back to Rajputana, Mumbai. Now the outstanding has changed, even the last bill has got added. It's showing a performance graph also. See, if you define a default salesperson in custom master, that salesperson will come by default. Since it's not defined, or maybe Suresh is defined in his master, so Suresh is coming automatically. And then let's say we give classmate again, 9-10 pieces left. Let's say we give 20 other pieces. It is automatically bringing 35 rupees. And the previous supply date also, it is showing that the last time you have supplied 35 rupees. This time if we give at 38, last time quantity was 100, this time quantity is only 20. So rate negotiation has went off. So next time it will start bringing 38 trade with the history that this date you ordered 100 at 35, then you ordered 20 pieces at 38. So this is how we enter the sales. Same way you can just go to options. All the options that we have seen in purchase will even be relevant here. If you select goods return here, it will be as a sales return. You click here and you can see a sales return voucher opening automatically from Rajputana. Once you come to reference, it will ask you against which bill are you returning the goods. Against the bill number 1. See, once you click this reference detail, no? As a part of GST also, when we are returning goods, we have to mention against which bill are we returning the goods. So are we returning against the bill number 3 or bill number 1? Let's say we are returning against bill number 1. How many pieces are we returning? Let's say some 5 pieces we are returning at 35 rupees. Bill number 1 we have taken at 35, so we are returning at that same rate. Now you save this. Once I save, it is asking me against which bill are you adjusting this amount. So let's say bill number 1 only I am adjusting 196 rupees. And I will save this transaction. Sales will reduce the stocks, sales return will again increase the stock. Correct? Sales will increase the customer's outstanding, sales return will again reduce the customer's outstanding. See, after adjusting this return against the bill number 1, if I go to options and select this status and voucher status, it will show that there's a sales for 64774 and then again a return has been adjusted against this 196. So current outstanding of this bill is 6578 only. Okay. This was with sales and sales return. Again, once we come back to our inventory and stock summary, we are seeing the detailed stock summary where even the output information will come down. 115 has gone out, 895 left in stock. 50 is out, 20 is out. Where all it has went, press enter, you get complete details of inwards and outwards. So this is minus 5, why? It's a return coming in. In outward, minus coming means it says sales return. That has happened. You can even see the transaction type here. Sales return. You press enter, you get the details. And last option here is the salesperson, sales register. With sales register, once you click show, by default the current date sales will be shown. You can see the sales for the month or for the week or for a particular date range. As you click the date range, you can define your own date range and you can set a date range also. This month. And click proceed. So it shows you all the sales that has happened and all the sales return that has happened. In other summaries, you can find out quickly like what all brand sales you have done. So Classmate total turnover is this much, Parker total turnover is this much. See, as we have defined all this in the master, now there's a possibility here. Category based sales, 100 pages book, how much you're selling, whether Classmate or whichever brand it is. Same way, gel pen, how much you're selling, ink pen, how much you're selling. And see group wise sales, and see books total sales, pen total sales. Tax summary will directly show you again 5% wise turnover and the tax amount split. All local sales only, so IGST has not come. SGST and CGST only is there. There's so many summary options available here. And you can even find out state-wise sales, city-wise sales, state-wise sales, how much is Mumbai sales, how much is Tamil Nadu sales. Likewise, you can find out different things here. If you have any cash sales also, it will show you a split of card credit sales, cash sales and the card sales at the bottom. And there are a few other register types here, like again columnar tax-wise, you will see different register types that are available. Tax-wise will give you bill-wise, turnover or split across different taxes column. Turnover and the tax amounts, expenses, round off any, and the grand total. Unprinted voucher list, bills which we have not printed yet. All everything is coming as unprinted now. Detailed register will give you bill wise. This is for accountant purpose, so you can export it to Excel also. This is a recent report which we have designed for GST, where all bill number. I mean bill date, bill number, account name, the GST number, product by serial number, product names, HSN code, quantity, taxable amount, tax rate, turnover, and different taxes. This has been requested by many of the accountants for data entry purposes. So this report can be generated and you can send an email to them. Entire bill summary is coming with individual product split. And other expenses in the entire bill also are being shown here. There are a few other options here like columnar group wise sales. When you see columnar group wise, it will show you bill wise, how much books you have sold, how much pen you have sold. There are multiple columns also, you can have all the group wise details coming here like textile, ready-made, kids wear, women's wear, men's wear, whatever groups that you have defined, same way category wise. When you see columnar category wise, bill wise you'll be able to find 100 pages what you have sold, gel, how much you have sold, ink, how much you have sold. Now all this report you need to explore. Commodity code wise is no more in, it's become obsolete now. HSN code wise you can just find out. HSN code wise will give you bill wise what HSN code number, how much turnover you have done. This is all relevant with GST now. Tender summary. How much is the payment made by cash? How much payment is made by card, credit? Those details will come. Bill wise, cash, credit and card. But right now everything is in credit, so everything you are getting only one column. Otherwise you will get a split of how much is credit, how much is cash, how much by card. We will see this report again while seeing the retail POS. That time you will get a tender summary. Daily payment summary will also give you date wise. Date wise will give you how much cash, credit and card is there. And there's a plus sign here by which you can see the bill wise details. This will be helpful in reconciliation of your bank statement or the cash. It's there in the front, I mean that part of your screen. I'll just open this plus sign. There's a plus sign at the beginning. Daily tax summary. Again, date wise you can find out the total taxation. Date wise how much is the turnover. This can even be useful for your auditors and accountants for different kind of reconciliation and filing purposes. There are multiple register types here. In a single report itself, we have so many things. Like daily, hourly sales summary. So date wise, for among 24 hours, it will give you details on how much sales you have done between 9 to 10, how much is between 10 to 11. So you can even analyze which date is your, I mean what time you are selling more and what is the time where you are selling less. Accordingly, you can introduce some happy hour schemes or you can do some other thing, plan up something else on during those hours. Or if sometimes where you, it's very peak and you can have additional resources during those times so that your sales goes smooth. So how daily hourly sales summary will give you this detail. Cancel voucher list and missing voucher numbers. Cancel voucher list will give you all the vouchers which are cancelled, so there's nothing cancelled yet. And missing voucher numbers will give you if there's any number missing in the sequence. If you're putting a bill like 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 100 and then mistakenly or suddenly you've deleted some 3 bills in between knowingly. That something is wrong in those bills and you are deleting. Later on you don't remember what bills you have deleted. Instead of scrolling across one by one and finding out among so many different bills, if you just give away the missing numbers, you can directly find out these numbers are missing in between the sequence. Other way of doing this is when customers, they have started entering data in March offer today, but they want to enter right from 2 months data, right from let's say GST. So they will parallelly enter the old data with old bill number, old dates and old transactions. But for today's billing, they will use current bill number. Let's say in July 1st, their bill number was 1. And today their bill number is running is 1500. So for current billing, we will give an option where there's a configuration where they can enter the bill number manually. So they will start bill number from 1500. But from bill number 1 till 1499 has to be entered in the system, which they will be doing simultaneously. Maybe one of the guys is doing that, but the counter sales cannot stop because even if the entire team is doing that thing only, then even today's thing will get added to the task log. So they will start billing with the software from today, but parallel they will keep entering the old transactions also. In that scenario also missing numbers will help you. Once you click that missing numbers will give you 1, 2, let's say you have 1 to 100 and then from 100 to 1499 is missing and 1500 numbers you are doing. Missing numbers should not be there. So you have a log that these numbers are yet to be entered and accordingly you can take required actions. So one single, all this report will be in similar layout format where you have register type, you have a show button, you have an options button where you can. Okay, options button you have not seen in the sales register. You can explore different things in the sales register. Once you click show it under options, if let's say you don't want returns together, then you can just take this include returns off. Likewise, you can filter multiple voucher types that we have here, or you can just see like only cash bills or only credit bills. So you can filter this kind of options. Or you want to see bills only from a particular salesperson, Suresh or Kumar or someone. Only that salesperson summary will come. Same way transport which has been, okay, there's no transport mentioned here. Otherwise from a particular transport only you want to see all the bills, then you can even trace that. There are many options available here. You can tick show salesperson, show GST number, show total serial number, show total quantity in each bill and just click apply. So you get few more columns coming here. So bill wise it is showing you GST number also. It is showing you total serial number, total three items are entered, 160 pieces are entered in this bill. There's even an option to show profits also. Show attachments, show time of the bill. What all columns are required, you can just enter all those columns. Show shipping address, show profits. Subtotals you want day wise or month wise or salesperson wise, if you want subtotal, you can even have salesperson wise subtotal. Or account wise subtotal also you can have. Account wise subtotal means automatically Rajputana Enterprises bills will get clubbed. So it says Ashok Opticals, one bill, this is the date, this is the time, this is the bill number, and all the columns are coming here. It is even showing the profits here. Profits as per the costing and the margins. 86 rupees you have earned. Same with Rajputana Enterprises, two bills. Bill number may be 1 and 3, but it is grouping all customer wise bill numbers together. So one single report, so many combinations are available with the customers. I mean, they find out almost everything in one single report itself. And there's even an option where you can print multiple bills from here itself. If you have not printed anything, you can select all or you can choose the bills that are required. Under print option, you can just click print vouchers. So this will print one by one all the bills together. Instead of you going to each and every bill and then printing, if you've entered so many old bills and you want to take a print copy of all those, select all the bills, click print vouchers, it will keep printing one by one. Or you can even export it to PDF, or you can send email, or you can print. In printouts, there can be multiple print formats, like laser format, or A4 half, A4 quarter, or dot matrix. What is the format? We have an option to configure almost those different print format types. And that will be a separate session again. The next session, we are learning about the print configurations and other options available on this trading screen. After the sales, this is the inventory that we have seen already. So today we'll stop with this, where we have not jumped into accounts yet. So we'll have a separate session for accounts, but sales, purchase, sales return, purchase return, and relevant stock effect, plus other options available in sales, the sales report, all the details we have seen in different variations, different combinations. So we'll stop with this. Thank you.